got a fat ass can of ultra flat black.
Yo, you about to go make this pass.
I'm passing
yo.
Right, right now, kid. I got some ism in my pocket. No
pass for me in a second.
Back this pass, box over.
Yo,
all up and down.
Yo, watch 5-0. Watch 5-0. Fuck that.
Stop that. Niggas
ain't getting caught, you know what I'm
saying? Fuck that.
Yo, pass that pilot, man. Pass that pilot, yo.
Yo, where's he down? I'm out to bomb like Vietnam, under the same name, Tame One, the bad one, ink flow master bastard with the magnum. I tags up quick, and then I steps to the exit when it's time to get sefted, or flex on some fresh shit, some whack crook. Throw my black book, I know who took it. I know it's so tagged because the fag writes his name crooked. The ink I use might stink, but you gotta think, I got my props, ops, cause my tags don't shrink. I'm tagging and bagging bitches cause my name is famous in the street, cause they know my name's from cruising in the Jeeps. So yo, grab a can and put your man up and stand up for the fresh, never stale niggas off the third rail. Deep dark and black like the Magnum I pack. It's that artifacts chat from the wrong side of the track.
The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side. The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side.
I load my backpack with spray paint to mark the sparker. Tagging every trip, I catch the path. Take a trip to the train yard to think back. When I used to write that shit that used to hit, had all the mad color tips. Breaking was my thing, I used to spin the back. I never thought I'd spin the wax with tracks to make your hands clap. I could've went the other way, but no how. I got my dap on the map with the big that's who a spray cap. Niggas used to doubt my clout, but now I turn them out. They shout my shit about town like they wanna be down. Avoid the crowds that wanna stab me in the back. Enough of that, watch the third rail track, cause I don't wanna get zapped. Pieces to burn to show my name, no shame. Don't wanna put the blame down on my nigga Tame. Brothers don't wanna see me grow to get my cash flow. I have the remorse, so check me out in the source.
The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side. The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side. The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side. The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side.
Like a tie stick, as red as my eyes get, I still rocks the fly shit. That was some ultra flat black, catch a wreck in a sec. Wet paint and shit when I'm on the set. I'm live like the third rail, on time like the pap train. The name same alone got fame, so fuck a last name. I tax mad when I drag a fat stack of ism, coming out with new additions like Mike Bivens. I get a sticker from my nigga with the back of him. Write my name on him, then I peel off the back of him. And stick him to victims of underground systems. If the toys bring the noise, me and my boys are gonna diss him. In conclusion, don't snooze when two niggas from New Jersey kick the mad graffiti slurs or kick the fakes to the curb. The artifacts, Jack, bringing the artifact back. Some seem to forget about the error that caught wreck. So remember this agenda when you slip in to enter the artifact zone, cause graffiti's still prone to kick ass, pizzazz, last time we tag. Why is that black? Because the whack jack was known as a fag. So don't cross the path, that's a gat to get back. The artifacts out, wrong side of the tracks.
The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side. The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side. The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side. The artifacts from the wrong side of the tracks. The artifacts from the wrong side.
That's how it is. Oh, you weren't talking that when I put you up, though.
Yo, put me up on that, all right?
Hey, put you up on this flip.
Yeah, where's going, yo?
Yo, man, who got my fat cap?
Max, Rasta Ron. There's Ron back there. I mean, I knew them first. My man Polo Ice, where you at? Put your hand up if you hear me. Ice and Jay Burn are responsible for me knowing Tame, besides his name on the street. My mother used to work at Macy's. Every time I would go to see her on a lunch break, I would see Porno Tame name underground here on Hawley Street. Every time I walked past it, I always wondered who the hell did that? Who did that? But I had the chance, but it was almost kind of like by mistake. I'm at Rhino House and I was doing demos, and one day Tame came over there. I don't know what that click was when I met him. I was already a fan. I was like, bro, I, you know, I know what you look like, man. That's crazy. And then I heard his songs. And I'm like, wow, my man Rhyme just as good as his name look on the wall. All right. So that's just that combination. But then that day, I think, I don't know if it was that day, maybe another day, we did a song. We got a song on the That's Them album called Break It Down.
Yes, as we continue to get it going on, artifacts representing from north to M town. Put your ear to this here. Most definitely, it's a sure banger. Keep this one in your collection. North to Ill town representing. Who do we have off the bat?
Get killed quick with the skill. Intact, ill with raps, building facts to fill. Gaps react, tap into your internet and batch into my steeds or my style. Yeah. Niggas down to make the cheese wild. MCs get the fuse cause I'm the bomb specialist. With the wettest, test this, deadly like asbestos. Check the credit, set it. So hard they have to call the medics. My paragraphs be off key, that's why niggas can't get it.
For those of you who don't know, my flow keeps MCs on freeze like Sub Z, doing MK3 fatality. Do remember like Clue. I run up on booty crews on every weekend, bugging out cause I be geeking. Lounge like the peppermint, the boom squad president leaves a tenement resident finding evidence of sedatives daily. Scooping through the roots like Alex Haley. Beetle belly beat down to a sound man looking scary. Label secretary terrorizer, get armor. Fresh rhymer, comma, bringer of the drama, the bomber. From the lost lands off hand claps, I run raps and shatter niggas' ciphers into pieces like gun claps.
Reach farther than Saturn. Yeah. Busting niggas up because my rhymes be breaking atoms. Adam Stranger, pro form arranger. Make USA polo shirt stainer with the tech that's never plainer. And then that's the men blend trends. We making course without the faking. Didn't say niggas respect, we just take it.
New Jacks relax because this syntax can't be Xerox. Because I be locked on spots like niggas moving it from SWAT. I X more men out than Elijah. Bahama Lee of rhyme schemes. Leaving my stickers at the crime scene. Squad odd man. Receive response like Roxanne. Battle the top man. And shock fans like I'm a rock band. I cut the mustard and plus I can bust it, dust it. What? Whatever you fucking with, I touch and leave it busted. My click rips and gets up in you like the shits from Grits. While yo shit sits like it's on bricks. Tracy chat raps, I laugh at. Half-ass rappers who lack fat tracks. Get capped at, fuck that.
Destroy the masses, niggas in classes trying to catch the math. As I sit and think, the ink begins to crack. My blueprints, instruments, working as I'm jerking. Your style hurting, in the club your crew nervous rehearsing. In between the cut, I run them up with mad stuff. Niggas can't touch, escape wax ciphers like handcuffs. So, come on and get down with that artifact sound.
Shit, I listen to Spanish music, Jamaican music, motherfucking anything, son. Shit is all good, done. As long as there's some good shit behind that bullshit.
Word up, you know what I mean?
That was the first song we did with Reno at his crib when we actually got together. Not knowing that after that day, we would be go on to do things that important things in my life that happened with him. This man called the radio station, won the battle, really wasn't a battle. He said that was it. Next week I called. It didn't matter what I did. He already was like, look, we going up there. Cool. My man Terrence used to work at my job, St. Michael's Hospital. He drove us up there. And a little Chevette that my friend let me hold for the night. While I'm going to stretch, he took his records from the house because he had to catch the train. Took his records, put them in the trunk, drove up there. This day, for 20 minutes, we freestyled off a Zulu war chant. And that was it. Mm. Next day, my man Reef, Stretch, Bob, y'all come to New York. We want to chill with y'all and have a meeting, not knowing that they was already plotting to put us to work. Going up to the label, I'm trying to fast forward. Going to the label, we was called That's Them. That was the name of our first group, That's Them. Go to the label, have a meeting, they say, yo, that name, I don't know. That name might not work on the record. We go home, we on the PAV train going back. I'm like, yo, what is we gonna do? I'm looking at him, he looking at me, I'm like, stared out the window. I don't know how the name, I just said, yo, artifact.
No number.
He looked at me, ain't no Google. None of that, we home in the encyclopedia, in the dictionary. You know what I mean, but we just wanted to see it in writing. And it worked. All right, just everything we still do, B-Boy and graffiti, is still, this is only 94, 93. We talking about this then, for the elements not being so much used. And we went back to the label. All right, what y'all want to do? Artifacts, proud. Like, what's up now, what? And they was like, okay, now we got to sit in his office and go through the computer and see if there's anybody else called Artifacts. Okay. Until 2 in the morning, nothing. We was good. What we did with T-Ray, Buck Wild, Redman, I still can't even tell y'all. We wasn't in the studio trying to make hits. We wasn't trying to make... We were just making songs. A couple of songs we had already recorded. And the song just started happening. T-Ray, you know, he came about because we wanted to get Pete Rock. We wanted to have Lord Professor Primo do beats. They said, y'all ain't got money for that. Cool. I said, we got T-Ray. I ain't bet. I said, well, what about the dude that did the Camp Front joint with Diamond and Sadat? Oh, that's Buck Wild. Oh, you can get him? We met Buck with Rock Raider in the studio. So all these things started happening magically. So where I remember the album was done. We had a meet, all the magazines came to the studio. We had a little meeting. Everybody could hit it with the record sound. Once it got the wrong side, they asked to repeat that song like 8 times. Label people in the room, and they whispered to me, oh, well, we know what the single gonna be. Cool, because that was the song that, and even still to this day, I told Tam, until we, it's gonna be that song. Because that song was the one song that we did registered with everybody on the planet. What got me through this week was looking at everybody's comments. Everybody's comments, I'm talking about of all ages, all races, all cultures. I'm seeing pieces going up now for him. And it just, it showed me and really put in perspective, even now, what me and Tame mean to a lot of people, even y'all in this room.
We love you.
That's right, bro.
We stand for everything that y'all stand for. This one dude had the best comment. I feel like y'all talking to me. But I also look at y'all, and I see my reflection in y'all.
That's right.
That was deep. So I say today, I'm going to wrap this up real quick. For everybody that's in this room that ever listened to anything me and Tame did, if you was a friend of him, anybody that wrote with him, celebrate him today and forever, because we all know it's going to be a point in time where we all going to go. But right. It's your mark that you leave on this planet that is your legacy. Right. Tame had the biggest legacy as much as his ego, his letters. The dude was very funny.
Yeah, he was.
Y'all don't know. My man, even when you didn't think nothing was funny, he would make you laugh.
Right.
I remember we was on stage one time, and he knew it was my turn to do my solo song. And he looked at me and said, yo, I'm gonna be right here. Chair was right there on the stage. I was like, because we was, you know, it was hot on the stage, and I knew it. He's like, look, man, when it's time for me to get back. I was like, numerous songs, where your skills at? He looked at every time Chaos put that song on, he would look at me and give me this look. Like, I know this is the one. I know. I got you. Every show, I tell him, I got your back. But the things that I will remember mostly about him is that he really cared about what he was giving to y'all. Mm. He took care in everything he did from, I mean, like, rhyme-wise, I still can't understand how this dude come up with these words, wordplay, metaphors, metaphor king. If he say, I do something like, I know it's going to be something that I know I ain't never heard. You know what I'm saying? Never said the same thing twice, never gave you the same feeling with every verse. So I'm going to tell y'all for real. Take light on what it is that you have, because I truly understood that for the 28 years that I was rhyming with. She had rooms with him, traveled with him, trains, you know, him and Chaos was like my brothers. I got, that's my brothers here, my real brothers here. I got two real brothers, biological, same as my third brother. I always told
him. This life is mine. God gave this land to me. This great and ancient land to me. And when the
nature all pro data for splattering. My chatterers pattern to seize what I greed. In excess of trees, a lavish home is all I need. Oh, the so exquisite prolific jet is here to present my testament in all closed circuit events. Respect the essence and build on my landfill. I'm so ill like the film, time to kill real. To real service for clarity in its best form. Above the norm, but to my culture stays warm. To my duties and laws, to refresh all y'all with the greatest of songs that can never go wrong. Do the next snap, back and forth. Realizing what you've been missing in lyrical exercising. It's no surprise that I'm bringing the good, swinging the wood like Pujols, prepare for a new host.
Crowd, please, I register off the meter. You know the business.
Keep it live.
973 since the code.
Transmitting live with the hardcore staff.
Crowd, please, I register off the meter.
You know the business.
Keep it live.
973 since the code.
Transmitting live with the hardcore staff.
Focus daily, my platform. With choice and voice, strive with a vocal approach considered moist. Duncan Hines rhymes, brownie points for the incline. I'm inclined to dim your whole shine. Tarnish your garments, pop your ornaments. Slice your spinners and embarrass you in tournaments. Don't forget when I first stepped on the scene. The boisterous, glorious, furious with a scheme of things. Lethal in fact, styles come in sacks of tens. Infamous like tape from backspin. Captain of the ship, Buckaroo Banzai. Master of the sword like Lee Mubai. For the cash and the flash and the gusto, must flow aggressively to rake in the dough. Take it all in, breathe and stop. Take a minute to reflect as I take it from the top.
Crowd, please, I register off the meter.
You know the business.
Keep it live.
973 since the code.
Transmitting live with the hardcore staff.
Crowd, please, I register off the meter.
You know the business.
Keep it live.
973 since the code.
Crown, world renown, all purpose for the sprint. Break the shit up into fragments. The dude, quick to eat up your food and rude manners. Kill files in my daily planner. The unflappable, hard like granite. Granted with the gift that'll spread across the planet. Lace the streets with my sound like 89. 99 the last year, hip hop had its time. Advertise myself and never dramatize. Like homicide, summarize on my social life. I'm well spoken like speakers at charities. Narratives that'll give pop off and shattering. Straight action pack, jumping through windows. Call bombs and hoes and beats that explode. All working, no playing on the job. K to the R's, ill mind on the floors.
Crowd, please, I register off the meter.
You know the business.
Keep it live.
973 since the code.
Transmitting live with the hardcore staff.
Crowd, please, I register off the meter.
You know the business.
Some of the faces that are here.
Yeah, yeah.
Be strong, bro.
Yeah, bro.
You got it, bro.
It's crazy. All right, check this out. So real quick. Tay-1 was my brother. And, you know, when I say my brother, we weren't blood, but I was a single child. I mean, I was the only child. My brother, Tame Raheem, was the only child.
He's jealous.
Right there. Mom's right there. And
this is Big's mom right there.
Yeah. And so, you know, me and Tame come from similar backgrounds. You know, we were only children. Single mother household. His mother and my mother were co-workers at the New York Blood Program, the Red Cross in New York City. They were co-workers, they were close friends, they were hanging buddies. Anytime they got together to go hang out, it was me and Tane. All right, now at this time, I was living on 110th Street in New York. So at this time, anytime Tane came to the crib, it was me, Tane, and usually my man right there, Luz FC. And, you know, that's what it was. When we first met, though, it was a company cookout that Red Cross was throwing out in Long Island. And my mom brought me, Darlene, brought Tame and A. Cool, my man Ant. So when I met Tame, I met A. Cool at that time. So at this time, we just Rick, Raheem, and Ant, right? You know, we... Me and Kel, me and Luz would take Tame to Riverside Park where they had the original Wild Style mural that was painted for the movie. It was right there, it was still fresh, untouched. We took Tame back there to show him that. And we were all in awe of that stuff. I mean, all we did was graffiti. Tame wasn't rhyming yet. He wasn't doing any of that yet. I wasn't DJing or making beats or any of that yet. We were just, we were babies. We were like 12 years old. Doing graffiti, breakdance, and just in the love of it all. Tame's mom's, Ma D, my other mother, she took us around to the graffiti galleries. Malik was there. Malik was, let me tell you, this is my other brother right here. You know, when I started coming out to Newark, you know, it would be me, Tame, and Malik, and Ma D would take us around to all the galleries and all of that stuff. Her, my mom, used to give us money, pay for the tickets for us to go to all of the Fresh Fest. We've been to all of the Run DMC shows. We went to the Beacon Theater. We went to Madison Square Garden, Nassau Coliseum. We was at the Fun House. We did all of that together. So we got to see all of that. Houdini, Fat Boys, UTFO, all of that. Run DMC, the day we met, Run DMC was all we recited. Sucker MC, that's all we cared about. You know what I'm saying? So that's my brother. I used to write Taxter when I was still in New York. I used to write Taxter. Tane would come, he would visit me, he would see what I wrote, he would come back to Jersey, to Newark, and he would start writing the same thing. So he was Taxter in New Jersey. So I changed my name, and I was writing Tane. Tane comes, he visits, he's checking us out. Took the name, brought it back to Jersey. And he lived with that forever. I don't know what it was. I don't know if it was how it sounded. I don't know if it was just the letters. But he loved that name. He stuck with it forever to the very end, as you can see. You know, Tame One, that's my brother. I'm going to miss him forever. We got mad history. I got so much history of him recorded. You know what I'm saying? Malik's got so much of his history drawn, you know what I'm saying, and painted. So that's our brother, that's our family. Thank y'all for coming out. Real quick, I'm just going to go through this obituary. Raheem had a harsh entry into this world, delivered at Newark's University Hospital with forceps. He was paralyzed on his left side. His mother, Darlene Harris, was strongly advised that the paralysis might gradually subside if she constantly made him work those muscles, interact and talk only to his left side. And slowly, the little fighter started responding to her with no issues anymore from birth. Seeing that, Raheem's grandparents, Raymond and Dorothy Brown, gave him his first pseudo tiger. Early on, Raheem was a latchkey kid. His mom commuted and worked long hours in New York. So instead of passing time watching black and white television, he was more interested in reading, And when he came, and when he became curious about the Encyclopedia Britannica, I had stored above the breakfast nook. On his own, he opened the first book, A to AR, and wasn't satisfied until he completed to Z. As he would say, those books put a battery in his back, and he named himself Encyclopedia Brown. Not adding the boy detective from the cartoon character. And real quick, I gotta say this. You know, when I was growing up, my mother was concerned about my level of reading, how much I was reading as a kid. Tame was one of those dudes, and I know Malik, me and Malik used to always talk about this when we were younger, that Tame was the type of dude would be in the house and he'll pick up whatever was around him and just start reading it, whether it was a magazine, a newspaper, a tape, anything. It was like he had to read. And that was inspiring to me, to see somebody my age who just had that hunger to read. I'm like, what's, you know, that made me want to read. I mean, he made me want to do more reading, you know what I'm saying? Tim was like that. Anyway, this is not a traditional obituary. Not gonna go deep into his music background, as that has been rehashed so many times over that not too much is out there that isn't really already known. And if you don't know, Google him. As Raheem evolved and became Tame One, he held tight and trusted his childhood friends early on. Their interaction was invaluable as they all matured, branched out, and understood and tapped into their God-given artistic and musical skills. Tame had met Rick Ward Rhino and dived into the vinyl records, which he was well familiar with, listening to his mother playing her collection through the years. Somewhere in the black and white composition book became one of the must-haves to write lyrics to develop and establish his unique spin on words, which remained with him to the very end. Elder Sensei came along later, but bouncing off their wordplay, they clicked, hence Artifacts was created. Later, Tame One, Anthony Miles, A Cool, Jerry Oxidine, J Burns Jaya, formed Boom Squad together. When he met Malik Griffin, DJ Porno, the excitement of their late night trips to New York City underground subways to paint, connect, and vibe with other graffiti artists. Backpacks and spray cans, and tagging with a wide assortment of colorful markers. Some whack crook stole my black book. I know who took it. All right. Kept him and his friends busy intensely, which seriously drawn in developing their individuality. His uncle Carlton watched his nephew become a rapper even before he became a man, and has always supported him from day one. Throughout Tame's lifetime, Boom Squad became and still is his family. They all grew up together, had good and bad times together, had and squashed beefs together. They were all there, but most of all, right there in solidarity, having Raheem's back through thick and thin. Even before he became Tame. Signing off, Raheem was baptized early on in his childhood, and he is now with God and at peace. Not dropping the mic, throwing it down. Big ups to my brother, Raheem Brown, a.k.a. Tame One Forever. Squad up.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Come on and get down with that artifact sound. But kids get wrecking, the beats bound to pound. We're struggling through the industry, BC. We gotta be the next shit that kicks, cause brothers ain't got it. In this rap shit, ain't no time for the dilly dally pally. Throw a match in the gasoline alley. Blew up mad spots. Kids was jealous for the props. See, the shit never stops. Hops just licking for my girls. Knock styles we make, never fake. Broke breaks in every crate. Old freestyles and dirty ass copied over tapes. Notify that the artifacts never never slack. While cruisers on stage whack, we just played the back. Now, the flip, tip, a rip, a split you with the picture. On cruise, so never pay dues, watch it for I get ya. Cause nowadays, it's the ways of the underground, but they're whack now. So, come on with the get down.
Come on with the come on, get down with the get down. Come on with the come on, get down with the get down.
Not, then ask some niggas who heard of me. The half on the artifacts in Jersey. Cause brothers be bugging, not giving love to the knuckles, saying fuck us. Cause we be shining brighter than the suckers. Shooting me prison, nobody listens to your dissing. Cause yo, my shit's legit, and as a lyricist, I'm hitting the high note. So why don't I smile when I take pictures? Cause now that I rock, I got more niggas on my jock than bitches. I just wanna do my dance with fams and slam into some hypeness. But biters and backstabbing rappers don't even like us. But props do. The source rap pages and the billboard, and read about the tours while you be flapping your jaws. I freak techniques, cause talk is cheaper than beepers from Broad Street. Punks pop junk, tame in the sense they leave them all beat. So people, I beat my technique freaks and how my shit sounds. Come on with the come on, get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Get down with the get down.
Hands up, your rap sucker, duck buck. The track's rough enough to prove a point that the niggas is the joint. Magazines we were seeing, now pop the tape in your deck. I got the heavy ammunition, cause I'm flexy with the tech. Niggas can't believe the artifacts achieved. Got tricks up my sleeves, so bow down on your knees. Yo, we ain't got the same lame, ordinary playing game. Put the shame in the crew who wants to feel the flame. So please submission to the rap recognition. My right hand is itching from the shit that I'm scripting. So pass the baton to the next runner up tame. I give a pound, so come on with the get down.
Hey yo, word to my grandma's tampons, I drop bombs. But since our demo tracks had gas, some shit my fat raps was half-assed. Watching others rockin' clock, we shocked them like a robot with our props. So now the naughty head niggas got more knots, yo. My pockets are bumpy chump, my drunk style is chunky dump. My disc and crisp, the funk and funk like Humpty Hump. Cause I'm coming from the underground, I'm down with the get down. MCs are used to diss us, get pissed cause they ain't shit now. The artifacts represent on every stage we step on. The days are getting stepped on, are dead because we keep on. Beeping these weak MCs who cheese with their baloney. Cause they're phony as fuck and couldn't bullshit off with tow trucks. So yo bro, now you know my flow, so go and sit down or come on with the come on, get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on, get down with the get down.
Come on with the come on,
get down with the get down.
Pretty much I met Tame, Rhino, Malik,
Rabbit,
you know, we all met through Max. You know, Max is the kind of guy, he bring everybody together, so you know, it was eventually we're always gonna meet. You know, I knew Max since childhood, you know. His mother and my mother were pregnant together with us, mm-hmm. working at Columbus Hospital downtown Newark.
Yeah, and I met Max downtown Newark, and not to cut you off, Jay, you know, we worked together, we brothers,
that's
like
right.
That. And me and Tame had it was actually a Tame and Anthony's crew, Anthony Miles crew, LTD, it was a graffiti crew, and we would hang out in front of Two Sweet Hawks place and share black books and trade secrets and stuff, and we'd go over to the art supply store and rack markers. If y'all don't know what that is, just steal the markers. And one day I was in there and I ran into Cool Mellow Max. I saw his tag on the testing card, and he was real slick. He's walking around, and I said, "You Max?" He said, "Yeah." So we ended up kicking it, and I ended up putting him down with LTD, and we formed what we call the Inner Circle. me, Tame, and Max. Tame called it Tampax. And so who Max, Jay got down. And it was weird because at the time, when I first started writing, I was writing Burn because of the comic book artist, John Byrne.
Me too, the same reason.
Right.
That's why we...
So, it, I don't know, we came to a mutual agreement. When I met him, I found out he was writing since 80. I started at 83.
Actually, so I started at 76.
Yeah, so I bowed down. But yeah, that's how we met.
And, you know, after that, we all met. And then I met L separately in high school. So we was in a group together. You know, we was called Project X. We used to do the talent shows and everything. And then, you know, pretty much after that, he brought me into, you know, I broke up. Because I was in college. And so I was like, you know, he called me up, tell me, you know, he won a rap battle against Tretch. Big Daddy Kane was one of the judges. He was excited about that because we saw his compete against Naughty and when it was New Style and they are like our rivals. I knew KG since kindergarten. You know, that's my man. I know his whole family, everything. We grew up together down the hill, Ken Top Stock.
He over there.
Shout out to KG. You know, and once me and L, I said, we still going to be in the group because I told him about Boss Mob.
Right.
You know, we was all in Boss Mob. I had joined by 87, so pretty much by that time, you know, when I went to college, I was like, well, we're going to break up, but I want you to hook up with Boss Mob. And he started going down there, doing music with Rhino, you know, Rhino CMZ, Cup Master Zone, you know, and then eventually from him, you know, Tame was going down there, but they was missing each other.
Right.
Then they just hooked up.
I think the first time they even brought Duke.
Yeah. And they just kept doing songs together, and it just worked out. It just clicked. And then they called themselves That's Them, and then they had to change their name when they got with Big Beat. They didn't like That's Them, so now we're here now. The Artifacts, they did what they did. 3 albums, many singles. They even broke up. They did their own separate albums, you know, and they got back together. Everything came around in full circle.
That's right.
They put one last album before Tame passed on to the afterlife, to paradise. And that's it, you know, and we're here today and we're gonna keep Tame name living forever.
That's right.
To be perfectly honest, I'm not feeling some of you rhymers. Most of you small timers is just a bunch of vaginas. Tame fans carry 380s down in their waistbands. Right with spray cans back in the days, they used to break dance. I got a following big on what I be hollering, and it's like mind boggling, cause I'm fly with a lot of them. I get the groupies that'll shoplift out of Gucci. Lap dance for the loot and smoke bomb by Z Lucci. My new stage show got underage hoes giving fellatio. Explaining why they don't play me on radio. I'm hard to market with the jar up in my pocket of the lethal. About to make Agent Orange a sequel. Shaking hands with people, exchanging drugs with a hug for chronic and kind, but in the middle of nightclubs. I took some time off, dry off, from now I'm back. Did you miss me? This is for when rappers attack. Dudes get paid, crews get slayed by the tools of the trade when rappers attack. Nothing is off limits, no room for the timid MCs turning to critics when rappers attack. And the show's throwing bows when the open bar closed, watching friends turn to foes when rappers attack. These darts with MCs part, so you street smarts to beat darts when rappers attack. Tame whistle, rock anybody you bring with ya. Sipping on champagne while I'm banging your brain tissue. Hit you with consecutive heat, repping the street, dip cigarettes in the leak, and blackout till next week. My second hand smoke requires an antidote, so breathe slow, cause I'm dope and y'all just placebos. Ask your people who the rapper that you beat for, with underground heat, just like them fat beat stores. This is it, but I spit'll break your media down. Tame One, aka Encyclopedia Brown. I think it's cool how I G-raps on P's and Q's. Who you think made it so cool to shout New Jerus? The OG without the 6'4 and house shoes, indeed. Smoking the leaves off your army fatigues. I be the new Hannibal Lecter from the New Jerus sector. And plus I incorporate game like John Schechter. Dudes get paid, crews get slayed by the tools of the trade when rappers attack. Nothing is off limits. No room for the timid MCs turning to critics when rappers attack. At shows throwing bows when the open bar closed. Watch your friends turn to foes when rappers attack. Beat starts from MCs part to you street smarts to beat darts. When rappers attack,
you might wind up a part of my disorderly conduct. I make rhymes up to do more than just take your time up. Grind enough words into a dust and then a puff it. Be right out in the public where I sell dimes of it. Burn bridges to light, dust is all from coughing. Blacking ever so often, so approach with caution. Could care less what you consider fresh and hot. And if I did, I would've opened a suggestion box. While the rest of y'all thinking you ballin' and act jiggy, I crack fillies and wish that I could bring back Biggie. And what I spit helps to identify flying objects. Clicks get addicted first time trying my concept. Unorthodox, something right off the block. With behavior that be having my neighbors calling the cops. I don't cop, please, I drop E's and threes. Blacking out like it's nighttime or cheap TVs.
Dudes get paid, crews get slayed by the tools of the trade when rappers attack. Nothing is off limits, no room for the timid MCs turning to critics when rappers attack. At shows throwing bows when the open bar closed. Watch your friends turn to foes when rappers attack. Beat starts when MCs part to you street smarts to beat darts when rappers attack.
And we were sitting in the back. I just know this kid was sitting in the back. He drew so fast. He didn't sketch anything out. He just went straight for it. And he was always laughing at somebody in the class, cracking up, you know, laughing, cracking jokes about their work. And so we kind of hit it off, and he introduced me to the X-Men comic books and John Byrne. And, you know, we attended that class for a couple of years, and then we lost contact. It's a weird story, y'all. About a year, we lost contact, and I'm sitting there. I'm going through a comic book. Captain America. I get to the back on the fan page. There it is, Raheem Brown. I said, oh, let me call. I dig up the number. I call him. We talk and we have a conversation. I said, so what high school are you going to? He said, Arts High. I said, me too. And so that first semester was crazy, y'all. I don't know if anybody from Arts High is in here, but they could tell you. The team and I, it was just crazy. The algebra class, he would give us so many problems. We'd sit there and talk and exchange work. So she said, I got a solution to this. She said, Malik, move one seat back so there's an empty seat there. So she goes to turn around right on the board. He slid the seat out the way and pushed the chair back and kept talking. So she turned around discussing, was just like, go to the office. You know? So, and it was weird because the whole time that we were at Saturday art classes, I knew him as Raheem. We were kids. So by the time we got to arts, he was tame. That was where I learned about Tame. And I was like, what's that? He said, oh, it's graffiti. You know, I've been with my cousin Lou, he's showing me graffiti tags and stuff. And that was the same year that Star Wars came out, and what's the other book? Somebody else, Subway Art came out. And we would sit there and we would just go through those books. Like Rhino said, Tame's mom would take us to the city and we'd go to the fun gallery. We cut class and stop at Henry's and go through his books. There were so many memories. We both got kicked out of Arts High School, needless to say. We watched each other grow up and become professionals. I'm really going to miss him. I'm going to keep it brief. I'm really going to miss him, and I just want to say that I love him, y'all. And I know everybody here has at least something with a Tame tag on it, so he did not leave us alone. Peace.
Artifacts on your FM dial.
We loading the barrel with high explosive ammo. Compatible in battle and anger, we're out for power. Rhymes in the satchel and action, we're rapping leisurely. Crush a nigga and wrestle on music expeditiously. Effective easily, lines breezy and certified. Live action in sequence to lead through points for better vibes. Tied bound, sound renowned, join
words, official black. Ill mind supported and sported with kicks and finger snaps. Young niggas lack aggression to last in this profession. We still impressive like first dates and last sessions. Raising the ante, cause ready up is mandatory. Glory is written, just spittin's only half the story. I render services, tend to urgent emergencies. New verbiage inserted, monitor short circuiting. We steady working, reliable, get a valued asset. So motherfucking intense, savage, consider classic.
A day in the street. Dip, slang rocks, bang locks. Back on the block, ready to get the Jesus back with you. You with me? A day in the street, it's most real. Dip, slang rocks, bang locks. Back on the block, ready to get this back with you. Every day.
Radio classic, non-generic rhyme for credit, record edits, synthetic dope for the narcoleptics. Don't sleep on the pope of the street, deeper than sharks, geek, dark meat. Broader than Broadway, hard as Broad Street. Long cabin, long top dog with data for cats. Rappers relax, my verses curse you out in all caps. Suitable musical touches, a few duchess and such. Rap celebrity status, I come through in the clutch. Apex predator, editor, etc. Dude, I'm nobody's fool, I'm nobody's fool. You wanna hate, too little, too late. The only thing to reciprocate for my piece of the pot, I want different cake. Shit is great, with ice cream on it. Old school cool is the green hornet. My off the corner performance, scream for it. I've seen arc with nauseous, cautious trendsetter. Pissed at people who sleep like bedwetter.
A day in the street. Dip, slang rocks, bang glocks. Back on the block, ready to get the Jesus back with you. You with me? A day in the street, it's most real. Gangs and slang rocks, bang locks. Back on the block, ready to get this back with you. Every day.
From another mother, Malik, Bird One, also known as Porn Griffin, and the Griffin family, the Artifacts Elder Sensei, Chris Calloway, Merge, DJ Chaos, RIP, LTD, and the Boom Squad family, DJ Rhino, Jay Byrne, A Cool, Prince, TC5, Cool Meal Max, we have Medi Bear over there, Med. So Tame One was a very important impact. He kicked the door in of hip hop when in Jersey was pretty much overlooked in terms of getting on.
Yes, sir.
He kicked the door in. He didn't have to go through several different solicitations of actually certifying a record deal. The first time they went around, the first time they went out was the first time they got the deal.
That's right.
And it made history. Not only was it that particular crew, but there were other crews that was involved. You had Do It All, Councilman Do It All, that was involved, and it had a very important impact on the history of hip hop in New Jersey. A lot of stuff had taken place on Ridgewood Avenue, if I'm not mistaken. Am I right? Yes. So a lot of stuff had taken place. But when they signed to Craig Common didn't really know how much good stuff he was getting. He was getting authentic hip hop. The first single ever to be written about graffiti ever. After that particular single, that's when KRS-One had created two subsequent singles dealing with graffiti. But there was no single, no hip hop, no song ever written, ever talked about in terms of graffiti. You can check it for your records. I'm a librarian and I can actually challenge you on it. You can do some fact finding. So back and forth to these particular studios, when you would see Tame walking downtown with his bag and with the reels and so on and so forth, dedicated not only going to Manhattan, New York, but going to places like New Rochelle, different parts of New York, meeting and greeting and talking with Lord Jamar and a lot of the noted figures of hip hop during that time. They kicked the door in. When he said that, I'm gonna do this and this is what I'm gonna do, he meant that. He meant that. So, you can say whatever you want about Tame. He was nice with the graffiti. He was nice with the lyrics. He was nice with the DJing. And he was nice with the pop lock breakdancing. That's a true hip hopper.
Yes, sir.
All around.
That's right.
All the elements. And graffiti is the first element. Graffiti is a standalone. You don't need the MC, the lyrics, although they're important. Graffiti was always a standalone, as far back as 1965. Thank you very much, and enjoy the program.
So we're honored to have Newark's own Dupre Kelly, councilman.
Right.
Also known as Do It All Do. Come on up.
Two.
The Weir can readily be described as a prison cell. But there's a vast difference between being stuck and being stuck mentally.
Yep, Charlamagne the God, Angela Yee. We are the World Book Dangerous Morning Show, The Breakfast Club. We got our partner in the building.
Yeah.
Pre-Do-It-All Kelly. What's happening, my brother?
Call him Mr. Do-It-All. Dupree Do-It-All Kelly is well known for being a member of the legendary hip-hop group Lords of the Underground, which won BET's Best Rap Group in the 90s.
He brought them on Lars Styles, Rosenberg, and Do-It-All, Lords of the Underground, also known as Dupree, running for councilman at large for the city of Newark.
Dupree Kelly, baby.
Dupree Kelly.
Oh, man, we've had him on the show before, but it's good to have him back in a different light. The one and only Dupree Do-It-All Kelly, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
You know what? I was just sitting over there thinking about my brother, and you know, usually at funerals we crying, and you know, Mama D, you know how I feel about you, and but this is a celebration.
Yes, it is.
I was just thinking about all of the stories and all of his brothers. Like Tame had a lot of brothers throughout New York and New Jersey, and I'm happy to be one of those guys and be amongst those guys, you know. My man right here. My brothers, I mean, L, you already know, man. You already know. And Porno, I remember coming to the Colonnades, man, and Tame brought me there. L and Tame brought me there. Like, no, you gotta go see these guys. You know, I met Tame and L from Dorian, Rockman, and you know, the Wonder Twins. If you know our history, you know who the Wonder Twins are. And you know, we brought Red Man along, and Red and Tame, Crazy Buzz, just hit it off. And you know, so I'm here in two capacities today. I'm here in a capacity of, you know, missing my brother and loving my brother and here for my brother, you know, as Do It All, Dupree Kelly from Lords of the Underground. But I'm also here as Councilman Dupree Kelly with a colleague of mine, Councilwoman, Reverend Louise Scott Roundtree. Before I call up the Councilwoman, I just want to say a couple of words on behalf of my brother Tame and Mr. Raheem. And being a councilman, you know, I've only been a councilman for 4 months, and we make history in Jersey, just like the Artifacts made history by making the first graffiti hip-hop song. We've made history by becoming the first platinum-selling elected official in the United States.
That's right. Jersey.
We got it for the world title in Belize. But Tame, you know, Raheem Tame One Brown wasn't just a graffiti artist or just a rapper. He was the definition of hip hop. He was a visionary with a vision that painted a picture with words, literally. Not only an artist and a musician, but a son and a brother to a lot of us. The first time I met Tame, I went to his house and he had graffiti and colored markers on all of the walls in his room. I said, my mother would have killed me. So when I met his mother, I went back home like talking slick, like, you ain't like Mama D. You gotta get with this hip hop thing. You can tell that Tame was different. And when I say he was funny, he called me Do Dirty for about 30 years. Do Dirty, Do Dirty. You know, I started to believe that was my name. He was soon going to become one of Newark, New Jersey's premier MCs.
Yeah.
And y'all know what I'm talking about. Like, I'm an MC, and Tame made you rewrite a rhyme. I know, I believe I rewrote a rhyme when I came to the Colonnades that day, too. So on this day, we're not just going to mourn him, but we're going to praise and thank him for his contribution to the great city of Newark, New Jersey, the Brick City, where he will ever be remembered as, him and L be remembered as That's Them. But on this day, you'll never forget. You'll always remember that Tame will always be an artifact. So that's from his brother, Mr. Do Dirty. But I want to bring up my colleague, that's ill to say, right? My colleague, the councilwoman, Reverend Louise Scott Brownson. I know they're on a time schedule, so we're not going to be long, but Ms. Darlene, I love you. Everybody that love my brother, I love you guys. I know Red Man is in here. Red, come up here for a second, please, bro. Like, come on, man. Like, everybody thought Reggie Noble and Raheem was really cousins.
Yeah. Somebody asked me.
These two are so crazy together, man. It's just unbelievable. And Red didn't come to talk because this is about Tame One today. But I just wanted to bring him up because Tame had pockets of crews. He had his New York crew. You know, he had about three or four different crews in Newark, New Jersey. But my crew that I was in was Tame, included the Wonder Twins, included Red Man, included, you know, Ella Sensei. It included the Governor and Diesel Don. It included Ahmed, and it included Porn and Rhino, and, you know, even though they were in separate crews, we all became a crew because of Tame.
Right.
Right.
He was a connector.
Yeah.
I mean, even when him and L was going through a spat, this is when I was producing Linkin Park Music Festival, and he was down there. You remember this story, yeah. And L, I said, L, I just saw Tame. I'm happy y'all going on. He said, I don't know. You got to talk to Tame. I said, what, y'all legends? What do you mean you're not going on? He said, you got to talk to Tame. I went to Tame. He's like, what up, Do Dirty? I was like, you going on? He was like, I don't know, you know. I said, man, if you and L don't get on that stage in front of North New Jersey, the Brick City, and shake hands. He put his foot up on the speaker, put his hand out, and that's when that's them, the artifacts got back together. And now, we are sad that he is gone. He's not no longer with us, but he is still with us. Mm-hmm. They created a masterful album with Buck Wild. Mm-hmm. A masterful album. I was with Buck Wild about a couple of weeks ago, and we were talking about the album. Tame is unbelievably an incredible wordsmith, and we're going to miss him, man. So I love you, Raheem, Tame One. Or Tame of Dizzle, as I always called him. He called me Do Dirty, I call him Tame of Dizzle. And I want to bring up the councilwoman. Thank you.
Chill.
LG Hobbs. Boom Squad in the. Chill. Hood Fab winning the socks.
Around.
Chill.
Tay Wizzle.
I'm back, ordering yak like short stacks for the syrup. The lyrics to turn some niggas into spirits when they hear it. Clearly you hear me not sounding similar to no simians. Despite opinions, I make dudes crash like they was pinions. The dudes to go hot, whole songs and studio drops. I don't know if you rock, but if so, I'm blowing your spot. Like this was foreplay, with my lips in some bitch's ear. Don't stress it, dissect it, left it to disappear. Roll bounce and skate it, underground basic as I make it. I've seen dudes fake it and hate it. Quasi-popular, semi-famous, partly notorious. Dark as my story is, still keep it ghetto as Nori is. Warrior spirit, self-admitted, bricks to these statistics. Special professional, lifted, misfit. I'm Bruce Lee of the loose leaf. Into the dragon, rapid assassin, the bragging crew chief. Involving half your street with a brand new beef. Credit critic, non-generic, or ethic delivered. All things considered, I get it, how I live it. The niggerest lyrics is Mr. Here It Is. Heard it, murdered it, every word of it, murdered it. Cross words out like a puzzle, had to circle it. So jerk a dick if you can't work with. Salujaru, journalist, earning piff. When I'm rocking, flow stopping, like a tourniquet, permanent. Resident evil, cerebral, these are the people, fucking devil. I see what I need to on other levels. Cause it's a God speed, God fine. Yours, I got mine.
Oh, we need this delicacy. Y'all need something. I'm saying one more time. Give it to Zion, you want to cry. So y'all need to make some noise.
James' worries are over. He don't have to worry. We're doing this. This is for us. We come together so we can get through the transitioning of a loved one. But his worries are over. He's somewhere up there writing, speaking, whatever he's doing. Dropping mics, calling him down, whatever. He is with the Lord. We're not there yet.
Be happy.
But while we got one more chance to get this thing right, let's just treat each other right. Love on one another. Amen. Call Mighty. Y'all say she was the mother of the community, the mother of the squad. Make sure you act like that when this is all over.
Right.
You got to tell the story. Check on her. Check on our own mother so you know how they do. Anyhow, I'm just going to stop right there. I'm going to become Councilwoman Roundtree right now. Once again, I thank you, Councilman Kelly. It's not easy transitioning from one level of work to another. He's been in this field more years than he's been a councilman, but I'm here to support him on every level. And any way that he has to walk, I will be by his side to support him, whether it's with the hip-hop crew, whether it's with the political folk, because I am here for humanity.
Right.
So as I stand here today, my assignment at one point used to be and I still do because his name is on my check no matter what nobody said, and that is Raz J. Baraka. People tell me once I got elected, was I still going to continue to do this work, which is encourage families and come and deal with mothers and fathers that have loved ones that have transitioned. Yes, I am. I'm going to continue to do that. That's important. Families need to know. They don't care how much you know until they know how much you care.
Right.
And the truth is, being elected, a lot of people just put you in a whole other box. But Councilman Kelly and I come to show you that we care so much, and on behalf of 311,000 residents, I stand today. I stand representing the highest office held, and that is of the mayor of the city of Newark. This is his letter of condolence to you. To the family of Raheem Ross Brown, who we all know as Tame One. Please allow me the opportunity to convey my sincerest and most heartfelt condolences for the tremendous transitioning of our loved one, Raheem Ross Brown, Tame One, of the legendary group Artifacts and many other areas of art that he played a part in. Having his journey to have started in the city of Newark at University Hospital, being introduced to the world, thinking that through his mother it was going to be very difficult, but it all worked out through his gifts. Surely we know that nothing can soothe the pain and grief of this loss to his family, his community, and friends. And because his transitioning was felt by so many, my family, along with the residents of this city, collectively share in your grief as we stand by your family during this time of mourning. But as a person of deep faith, I believe that weeping may endure through the night, but joy cometh in the morning. Amen. Though we may feel sorrow's depth right now, we trust that our beloved Raheem Ross Brown, known as Tame One, is resting in the arms of God. With my deepest sympathy, Raz J. Baraka, Mayor, City of Newark.
Amen.
As I go to my seat, I don't do this. I know we got to get out of here. I know there's a time thing. But you know what? There's always time for a 30-second prayer. And that is, may God continue to be in all of you to strengthen you, especially you. May God continue to be beneath you to support you, go before you to guide you, keep arms of protection around you, angels encamped over you as a shelter, as Tame One has now joined the ancestors to watch over you. We shall be careful not to take credit for what God has done, because even in our grief, this is the day God has made, and we're going to have to do what we got to do in it. Amen. No matter what you call God, it's amen, amen, and ashe. God bless you.
We got to get out of here for one last thing before we get out of here. Since I'm councilman, I'm about to use my power of the office for my brother one last time. I'm a Westwater. You know it's a lot of Westwater people in here. I heard Poav in here. You know, the hood is definitely in here.
What's
up? You know, it's a lot of, you know, we got a lot of great hip-hop talent throughout this city. But nobody's produced platinum and big-selling artists like the Westwater. Y'all know that's true. That's not even a stab at anybody else. But the Westwater also produced Tame One.
That's right.
You know, so in the Westwater, I need anybody, we're going to do a memorial for him through the power of my office in the West Ward. And it's going to be, we're right now identifying a wall for all of the graph artists that want to celebrate and do it for a Tame. And it's going to stay there. Because I know how you graph artists get down. You got respect for each other. And if you don't, it's messed up. But we all got respect for Tame. So I want everybody... Ella Sensei is going to lead that push. My office is going to allow, you know, get the wall for him. We're going to have a resolution for him. We're going to shut the street down, whatever, all of that day. And we're going to celebrate Tame One on that day. As soon as we identify the wall, Ella Sensei, I have the date. And I'm going to flex the power of my office to memorialize my brother, Raheem Tame One Brown. In the West.
Few more comments. We're gonna bring up Reggie Noble, aka Redman.
I'm high. Motherfuckers grab your glasses, that funk doctor spot to be my wick tech machine guns. I'm high as Bob Marley, getting coked up. Not hardly cause the shit I puff and stuff in the pico up on the ski slope to make it nauseous. Bang the boogie to the up jump. Bitch, don't wait till the cut's done to turn it up, son. I rock it if you Greek, Puerto Rican, German, and Spanish. And I don't need to be Houdini to make a city vanish.
Cause everybody's
out
under the sun.
And I'm looking for the devil coming to your live, nigga. With the Cambo fever, straight out of New Jersey and Uptown. 99.4 to Alps FM.
Yo, we're not here to niggas like us get blooded every motherfucking day. 24/7, you
sweeter than Perot. Put your motherfucking fingers up in the air for the funkadelic like this, and let me hear you say, ah.
Word is born for all the niggas out there. It's Rockwild in the house for the 94 deck. Saying what's up to all my people in the New York area, in the Jersey area. Like that, y'all, it would kick it a little something like that. Enough love go out to the Crossbreed crew.
Word up.
And a man.
Yo, the DJ Twin shouting out to all my niggas represent from Brooklyn. I'm high like an eagle. And fuck the bitch ass cops that pull out Glocks and blast my people. I'm like drunk, so what up? Nigga, back up. Take off those LA gears, cause I'm about to light your ass up. I smoke the funky one, the skunky one. I roll the chunky one. My slips deeper than hell when you bungee jump. Wop, wop, a loop, bop. Pistol pack, two glocks. And I'm the fucking reason cop cars are more than two pops. I'm known for breaking battles and breaks. Jersey earthquakes. And he couldn't win if you had Reverend Ike on the church day. But a bunch of bitches ain't it, cause she think I'm famous. Check her. And I eat a twat like it's a Danish from a banquet record. Shit out the socket, bitch, I come correct. Smoke blunts in many hoods and got dumb respect. Residues with crews on avenues I puff. Left niggas coming toast with they eyes shut. Put your blunts up in the air and do what you gon' do. Because this the type of folk you smoke a blunt to.
Well, yeah, niggas smoke out forever because we definitely getting high.
Your bitches and your niggas throw your blunts up in the air and get high like an eagle. I'm smoking food and do the ball and get high like an eagle. I said, who's up, side chicken? I said, who's up, side chicken? Yo, what's up? This bitch, they got Remo. About the South Central LA, you know what I'm saying? Inglewood, double I. Inglewood to Hilltown, nigga, act like you know. Road dogs, nigga. I'm out in the 90s. Waking up in the morning and I'm comatose. My brain's on fire and I'm higher than an empire. I'm zoned out, plus I smoke about 30 times alone. I could they fake niggas on three, pull your microphones out. Breaking the setup, strictly demolish all the garbage. Cause I'm deeper than carpet or starfish from the water.
I'm drowning.
I smoke a blunt with the great white shark while we cruise on Noah's Ark. Thanks for Biz for taking me to my Tosello Park. Fuck Miss Brady on down and you dead to start with. A wicked like you hit the picket. I what you call the swiftest. The first guy on the moon and I had no in touch with Memphis.
Don't need no visine on my nines to get the lead out. You need more than visine in the eyes to get the red out.
I rack them up like pool tables. It's that smooth fatal lyricist when I'm split. I'm known to rock any fool's cradle. I stay raised so I corrupt and down some other shit. Cause all day I have the soul to make any motherfucker flip. And the chocolate tie never stops. True, this the folk you smoke a blunt to.
All right, all right. God is great. God is so amazing. I'm gonna keep it real short. I'm from the days of Boom Squad. I'm from the days of That's Them. Matter of fact, I love the name That's Them. I even argued with Tame about it when he wanted to change it. But I'm from the nights of, you know, Mama House on Central Avenue. You know, late nights, lots of music, knocking on the wall, turn the music down. I'm from that day. And my mother name is Darlene too, so that's why me and Tame said, yo, cuzzo, you know what I'm talking about? But I want to let you guys know, we are no Tame the artist, we are no Tame the graffiti artist, the music artist, but I want to tell y'all a little story about Tame, the love of Tame, and the loyalty of Tame, which helped change my life. So when I got down with EPMD. Everyone know who EPMD is, right?
Yes.
And when I got down, my city got down. Now, if I was on, my city was on. I brought the tape of Do It All, Do Pray Kelly over to EPMD. And me and Tame and Diesel Don, we did a freestyle over at OGB, right? And I had that tape. And I said, I want to do something so I could let them hear it. Immediately, when I let EPMD hear Tame, they wanted to sign him just like they wanted to sign me. And I told Tame, I said, yo, we on, bro. Like, yo, come over to New York. They want to meet you. Like, we on. And Tame got quiet for a second and said, I will not leave my brother Elder Sensei. That's a big fact. That's a big fact. And, you know, I thought I was grand trying to bring all my brothers along with me, but he showed me another level of loyalty. Just stuck with me to this day. Like, big facts, Mama D, big facts. Like, I said, wait a minute. I said, Tame, I said, I know you and L, that's them. I know you loyal. I said, maybe you can just bring them on when you get on.
And I said, I'm going to ask you again, Tame. They really, I called them back the next week. I said, Tame, they really want to meet you. And he said, no, I will not leave my brother Elder Sensei for no one. And that taught me a strong lesson in life about love and loyalty, and never letting your loyalty be tainted by money or the fabric of this industry. I always say that you can always tell a person cup is full with the word and love, but on how the way they treat people. You understand what I'm saying? And anytime Tame was around anyone, he treated people with respect, he treated people with love, and he never let his pride get in the way, because we all know pride is a sin, and pride won't allow you to be vulnerable. And Tame was not afraid to be vulnerable. He was always representing who he came from, which is mother. He always showed love to his mother, whether we was in the streets or in the industry. He was always the same. And when we would go out on the road and I come back and I see Tame, when I seen him, I always felt at home. Always felt I was back. So Tame, I'ma miss you. You know, Cuzzo, I love you forever. I'ma always ride for you and represent who you are, you know, and what you stand for. And that is loyalty and love. Cause we need a lot of love in this day and age right now. And that's what Tame was. So thank you.
And right before that, just please come on up.
Peace, everybody. How y'all doing? My name is Justin, professionally known as Just Blaze. I'm a producer, DJ, and I've done a lot. I've done well for myself, right? You know, like somebody I know who I am. Check out, I didn't see you back there. I've sold a lot of records. Done very well. I set up for a reason. Because of the artists that I'm associated with, when I get interviewed, had a conversation about this, and I get interviewed a lot. People will always ask about pivotal moments in my career. And they always say, oh, must have been, you know, like, turning point was Jay-Z, the turning point was Eminem, or whatever. And I'm like, actually, no, it was this club called The Pipeline.
Yeah!
So, I tell the story all the time, but, like, I literally just told it again, about a month ago. You know, growing up, I grew up in Paris, right? And seeing, you know, I was a video music box kid, right? We didn't even have cables. I didn't have any TVs. I was a video music box kid. So all these rappers were superheroes. It was like something you read in a comic book. They weren't really tangible, right? And I make this as quick as possible, but going through my path and trying to, you know, make this dream a reality. You know, I was able to meet Flat 45, who then introduced me to porn. And once I got to Newark, once I moved out here, once I came out here. And porn, you know, being the generous OG that he was, used to let me DJ at the Pipeline. And it was the open mic Wednesdays, and I would play, you know, when I had the open mic, I'd be playing records, you know, playing whatever instrument I was at the time. And eventually I worked up the courage to play my own beats as interludes in between the artists that were coming up to rhyme. And one night, I don't know, Z is still here, Alice was there, and Tame and L with him. And I remember Tame and L had gone up, and I played whatever record was out, and I was about to, you know, whatever commercial record was, whatever the record was, that was kind of the song. And they were like, nah, yo, put that other beat back on. So I'm thinking they're talking about the previous record that I had played. They're like, no, the beat you was just playing. I'm like, that's my beat. They're like, yeah, play that. I'm like, you want to rhyme on my beat? But that was such a affirmation for me that what I was doing, I might be on the right path. And, and that time that I had spent, you know, in that venue with everybody, had that phase of my life not occurred, like, I might not be sitting here speaking to you guys just now. So, and I used to tell people about that all the time, you know, like, he wasn't the guy that I spoke to every day. He would speak often, but not every day. You know, as a lot of the other family members did, but whatever we did, it was always love. It was always mutual respect, you know. I'm glad to get it. Thank you. One other thing. So, you know, we always say, yo, they're still with us. They're still watching over us. They're still... It's a cliche thing that people say at funerals and times like this, right? But Malik, you know, I called you about this the other day. Malik asked me to speak, and I was like, nah. Because I don't want to... I'm good on TV. I'm good behind a woman. I'm on the camera. A situation like this where it's real people and real things happen, and I don't speak that. And I was sitting there with my wife, and we're at the kitchen table, and I said, you know, to your partner, I was going to speak. And I was like, she was like, I was going to do it. I was like, my phone is in my pocket, right? And I was downstairs listening to music. My phone is still playing music. My iTunes is completely 100% on shuffle. And I got about 70,000 songs in my phone. And she said, we're going to do it. And I said, I don't know how I feel about it. You know, like, I'm kind of afraid to speak it in a situation like that. Same way I'm stuttering now. And as soon as I said that, Tame's the moment I feared came on.
You know what I'm saying, so I say. You know what I'm saying, so I say. I had to listen to your mixtape, written my tape. The last song on the tape, oh, what a relief. The music sounded booty and as rigid as 10. So I took it out, then I put my own tape in. Now I'm happy as can be, it's working out so well. People said I couldn't do it on the mic without L. It's the year 2000, niggas sounding like hell. Put out independent singles, hoping my shit sells. Now back on the scene, I don't bother no one. I roll strictly with the squad, let me do Tame One. All my blacking out is over, it's time to have fun. I be smoking Isabella with this kid named John. Getting blunted up in front of clubs in NYC. We went to this open mic event and got in free. Grabbing all the girlies' booties, taking ecstasy. Cause I'm a wild North nigga and they don't stress me. Durbin J has split the Vega for some light green smoke. And the club security was looking all down my throat. Is it cause I'm Tame and I'm always blunted? Security ran down telling me to dud it. It was the moment I fed.
Yo, 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 you can't play this up in here. Take it down five times, yo.
It's the moment I fed.
Yo, don't make me take it from you. Put it out and get out, motherfuckers.
I said, yo, this is the deal. We only came for the girls. And for you taking my Dutch, ain't no way in the world. He said, Tame, you know the game and how the NY changed. Kicked us out the club and had to go back home on the train. So I went to a Buddha spot, then we got us a nick. So we smoked and we joked about some industry shit. Saw my money on the block with this chick named Brenda. I used to hit, but I acted like I couldn't remember. She shouted me out, but I really couldn't hear her. So I got a little bit closer just to hear a little clearer. She said, I'm looking for Salem, where I think they sell weed at. I said, I know where that's at, cause that's around where I be at. I gave her the information and she went on her way. I went home and took it down till almost 2 the next day. Someone's ringing my bell, I opened up Word Bond. It was Brenda half naked with an edible thong. Tried to suit me and seduce me, and at first I wasn't with it. Then she licked it and I hit it, then we did it and we did it. She said it was great, she said she's glad we had done it. I walked into the bus but Money Grip was on it. It was the moment I fed. Yo, what is you doing with your head all over my girl's ass, dude? What are you doing up here?
Hold up, take it up.
I just know y'all ain't your thing. Y'all check your bitch. Well, he was wildin' out in the black, and then he swung on me.
Word.
So I pulled out the weapon, then I silenced the hoe. Then he was dead, to the head, I took the cash and the visa. She said, we got a murk, not wanting people to see us. We went up to the crib, she had some leak in the freezer. She said, we're rich, we can have whatever would please us. Now, I don't fuck with nothing that ain't good for my health. So I put this booger's head out, then I went for death. Now, I was rich, yes, I was rich, I could have whatever would please me. Rock jewels in front of the haters that used to tease me. Cock me, spot me jumping out of the truck. Kiss me running up on screaming, yo, Tame, what's up? I guess I was too flossy, but I'm sorry to say. Because this copper ran up on me, Tame, make my day. I said, relax, brother. But he had proved that I had done it. Because he had poor purpose underwear with my fingerprints on it. This was the rise and fall of my ill lifestyle. Because I was the main event on the TV for a while. But now I'm in jail doing life and it's beat. Because every time I take a shower, niggas trying to pee. It was the moment I fed.
Yo, what you got up under that towel, man? Rock,
nigga, come here for a minute. Yo, it was the moment I fed. Yo, y'all fucking butt pirates better back the fuck up. It was the moment I fed. Sling Rack. Guess who's back? Ricky Walters.
Smoother cap.
Raheem Brown. Eastern Conference in the Boom Squad in the hall. Cause that's the way it has to be. Jokers are wild if you wanna be Tame. Deep concentration, cause I'm no comedian.
moment I feel.
It could have been awesome. Any time song either, right?
Moment
but the
I
fact
feel.
That it was that record, I had to stop. Like, I got my every hair on my body was standing up, and I had to call him like, yo, are you okay? Just making sure that, I don't know what the sign was, but I just got a sign from him, so you're the closest person I know to him. I'm calling you, check on you. So yeah, he's still with us. He's still sending messages, and you know he'll always be part of our lives and our hearts. So.
Tame One and MCL, we be the ultimate.